Whenever you're practicing backward bending exercises, understand that the first thing you should always do is thinking of lengthening the spine, like pulling the spine apart, that when you're starting to go into the backward bend, your vertebrae are not sitting on top of each other. So you lengthen them and then you start bending them. Now the bow pose, before we start practicing that, I would recommend practice the cobra first so that you learn that first movement in the neck. You find a tutorial here where I explain very precisely as to how to practice that. Just as a little review, what we want to do in this position, you will start with bending the legs and trying to hold on to your ankles. Now the first part of the movement is kind of like you practice the cobra. You want to lengthen the spine, so you imagine you're pulling the head out. And then you'll just scoop up without lifting the chest or without pulling any traction on your hands. This is just my neck muscle rolling up. So you can feel how the throat will open up. The chin wants to strive up, so this entire part of your neck will be activated. The next part of the movement is that you will pull the legs back toward the back walls. Okay, don't try to lift here yet. First you scoop the head, then you pull the legs back. You can feel how that upward scoop of your head will be supported and go into your thoracic spine. And then when you're here, the last part that you want to do is lift the knees up. And now you're arching the entire spine backwards. A lot of times I see that people, once they start pulling on the legs, forget about the head, and the head tilts forward again. But it should be that the head pulls back the entire time so that really the entire spine is engaged in this position. And then when you come out, you'll do the same way, just reversed. You'll first bring the legs down, then release the hands, and then slowly allow the head to come down.